How's it going, everyone? Hope you're doing well. Welcome back to the next episode of The Walking Dead for the PS3. It's a Femoral Rift, and for those of you who don't know, this is a new storyline that does take place during the events that occur in both the comic book and the TV show. The main character here is Lee, and we are at Herschel's farm, the same Herschel. This is before the walkers are in the barn. So this is a little bit earlier on than the events that occur in the TV show and the comic book. So, see what everyone has to say. This is the little girl that is going to tag along with us through most of the, probably through the entire video game.
You having a nice time with Katya Clementine?
Yeah.
Hey there, girls.
How was the city?
How did you handle getting through the city?
Kenny just drove. We passed so many people that needed help, and we just passed people over some, just...
It's okay. It's fine. You don't have to say anymore.
I want to go home tomorrow, but even then I can't take away the things Doc went through. Don't you want to go back to the moment before you knew about all of this?
Things could all be
providence, you know?
Not what we saw.
You just never realize when something is happening to you, what you're being given. Maybe this will all work out.
Your optimism is refreshing. New. These past couple days, at least.
What do you do?
So, what do you do when corpses aren't walking around?
I'm a veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale. Like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
I used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon, Lee. Back to normal. It can't stay like this.
No, I used
to. I used to. I was let go a little while back.
That's too bad. Well, I hear people always clamor back to college after a big disaster. People don't want to die ignorant, I guess.
You two actually look relaxed.
You two actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah. So, you're good?
Anyway. It's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful here, no?
Back in a bit.
Okay, Lee.
All right, let's mosey on over here. And talk to Kenny.
Hey there, Kenny.
How's your son doing?
How's your son doing?
Good, I think. Katya's got a sister up in Memphis. We were coming back from visiting her. We were in a gas station and some guy grabbed my boy. I thought he was kidnapping him. I was on the fucker in about 2 seconds and... Christ. Just lucky I was there. We saw a lot of bodies before we stumbled upon Herschel's. But we're a tough family, Lee. Ain't nothing gonna faze us.
What's your plan?
So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. Government will start handing out shots and the National Guard will do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess.
You've got a boat?
I'm a commercial fisherman, catching mackerel, dolphin, whatever's biting and paying. Katya wouldn't be wild about it, but the boat's not that bad.
Need any help?
Need any help?
No, I think I got it. Do you need any help?
What do you mean?
I mean, in taking care of that little girl. You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
I have no idea. No kids.
Nah, no kids.
Would have liked one then.
You know. See ya.
It's not the most reliable pickup in the world, but it gets the job done.
All right. There's not much to really do, so we're just gonna mosey on around over here.
You know how to drive it?
Sure don't. I can give you a hell of a critique of the U.S. Farm Bill, though.
I'm good.
And let's look at Duck. What's up? And then let's talk.
How you doing,
Duck.
Duck?
Good. I'm gonna drive the tractor. I'm the foreman. Lift with your back, Sean.
All right, then we're gonna talk to Sean.
Hey, Lee.
Need a hand?
Need a hand?
That'd be great. If you could cut those two bys to length, that'd sure speed things up. My dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
I saw a guy get stabbed in the heart with a trident.
You gotta do what you can to survive.
Like put a gun to that kid's head and pull the trigger? Fuck that, man. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
Did you have to do it?
Do what?
Kill. Have you had to off one yet?
Oh.
I had to shoot one.
I had to shoot one.
I could shoot one, maybe, if it were far away. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built. Dad just wants to keep the family safe and thinks inviting people in is a bigger threat than whatever's out there. How about yours? How's your family?
I don't know where my ex-wife is.
I'm not quite sure where my ex-wife is.
Ah. Oh. Yeah. For sure. That's probably all I need cut for now. Thanks.
And Sean, thanks again for the ride.
No problem, Lee. Couldn't leave you behind. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help in the barn.
How'd you get out of Atlanta?
I got a ride.
I got a ride and then I was in a wreck. I walked until your boy found me.
Well, you're no worse for wear.
This farm's a nice plot of land.
Had you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this. It was in the family, and I guess so was I. Family's important. It's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now? Parents? Wife? Girlfriend?
No wife anymore.
No wife. Not anymore. I think she's up in Virginia, maybe.
Sorry to hear it. But now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
I was looking for help in her house.
Can I give you a piece of advice?
Sure.
Sure.
I don't know who you are or what you did. Let's say things don't get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're gonna have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're gonna make it. And if those same people get to questioning yours, you're gonna be in trouble. at least you have the common sense to listen to a man giving you advice.
What the? Go! I'll get my gun!
The good times, bro. Decision.
My leg is
help Sean.
Stuck.
Help Duck. Oh, we're gonna help Duck.
Help me! I got you. Now, Sean.
Get this tractor off of me!
Intense. He pretty much dies no matter which option you choose.
Get out.
Get the fuck out of here!
I'm sorry.
Sorry?
Your son is alive.
You don't get to be sorry. And you!
You didn't even try to help.
I was worried about the little boy.
I was worried about the boy.
Look at him.
But you weren't worried about that.
Please. Just go.
Get out and never come back.
Got that ride to Macon if you want it.
So the reason I decided to do that is because the storyline with Kenny goes on for a bit, and wanted to have a better relationship, so to speak, with him, with Lee's character.
Well, this is as far as we're going.
And it's far enough.
So now we're on to the next part. Or chapter, maybe.
Look!
Hey there. You friendly? Truck's run out of gas.
Yeah.
Fuck!
Not too friendly. Oh, look. Welcoming committee.
We're trapped! No! No!
Run!
And there's Glenn.
We can't take risks like this. And we can't just let people die, either. When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. They could be dangerous.
Worse, they could have led them right to us.
Where the hell is your humanity? They would have died out there.
We have kids with us.
I see one little girl.
What is it?
I have to pee.
I'd go out there again in a second.
In a minute.
I bet you would. You're a dumb, careless kid.
In a minute, Clem.
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common.
God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
Carly and Glenn just ran out there.
She's an asshole. She's not wrong. She's the leader.
Fuck. We're in a war zone.
She's an asshole, that's for sure.
That's what it takes.
Well, you don't have to be a bitch about it.
Holy shit. Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
He wasn't bitten.
Hell, he wasn't. We have to end this now.
Over my dead body.
We'll dig one hole.
No, I'm cleaning him up. There's no bite. He's fine.
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen. We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten. Shut up. We gotta throw him out, or smash his head in.
Kenny, stop him!
Hey, what do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy.
Dad, you need to calm down.
We kick his ass.
That's what I'm thinking.
Everyone, chill the fuck out! Nobody is doing anything.
Shut up, Lily. And you, shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here, and none of this will fucking matter. But right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
What the hell are you talking about?
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten. Lee, stop this. It's upsetting him.
Oh, I'm upsetting him. Upsetting is getting eaten alive.
It's his son.
We get it. It's a big deal.
It's Larry, right? Man, this is his son.
Look around, dumbass. I got a daughter in here. You got a daughter in here. Get your head out of your ass, boy.
We've all got people in here. We can figure this out without killing anybody. There's another way.
Yeah, with a shovel.
I'm gonna kill him, Cat. Just worry about Duck.
Lee!
Yeah?
There's someone in there.
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter. Probably.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter.
No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid.
He's covered in muck. She'll find the bite. Watch.
She won't.
And if she does, the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face. Then, when she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl.
Deal with it.
She'll turn fast. And then, there'll be three.
Then we deal with it then. But right now, we're just freaking everybody out.
Then get ready to deal with it, because that boy is bitten.
It's not gonna happen.
It is. And we're tossing him out now.
Knock this guy out.
Happily.
Jesus.
Oh, man.
Jesus!
Clementine!
Damn, I didn't know that either. Knock out Kenny. Rescue Clementine.
Get away from her, you son of a bitch!
Oh, not good.
Get off!
Come on. Nice shooting, Dex.
You okay?
Just great, thanks.
Guys?
They're gonna get in!
Shut up!
Well, I guess he didn't knock out Kenny.
Is that the military?
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is.
We almost died because of this bitch and her itchy trigger finger. That was stupid! That was...
Dad!
Too bad he didn't have a heart attack right there. I told him to calm down.
You did try to get him to calm down.
Can it, asshole? It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills?
Yes, we're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
Looking for...
What are we looking for?
We need nitroglycerin pills. Please get in there. I'll keep an eye on my dad.
Everyone else should get comfy and look for anything useful. We could be in here a while.
I'm starting to think this drugstore isn't a permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
Then I'll head out and get gas. There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
You know your way around town.
You know your way around? Local?
Born and raised.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully, you won't need it.
Cool.
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you, what's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest. You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
All right, so, like I kind of alluded to earlier, I'm trying to choose some dialogue options that are gonna have a better outcome between Lee and Kenny's relationship. Because I heard a couple of viewers say that it's just a little bit more dynamic. Anyway, in my previous playthrough, I wasn't the best friend to Kenny, so to speak.
Central High Tech State. Paper's a week old. Feels like years.
Check out some things.
Looks like nobody got a chance to donate anything before this all went down.
Take a look around. Talk to some people.
Hey there.
Hi.
Can I get you anything?
Can I, get you anything?
I'm okay. Maybe I'm a little hungry.
I'll see about that.
Any word from Glenn?
Nothing. Is he okay?
Yeah, I think so. You're doing a good job.
We should get to know each other.
So,
are you okay?
What? Yeah, I'm fine. I just, I'm good.
That's good.
Yeah, I think so. Being good is good, despite the circumstances.
Yep.
Well, sit tight.
Okay.
And you can tell he's not good at... quite comfortable being the father. Or playing the father role. Looking for some energy bars here. There's about three or so in this place. Let's go talk to these
How's
folks.
I'm not sure I got your name.
It's Lee.
Lily. My dad's Larry. I was just doing what I had to earlier.
Everyone was.
You didn't have to call me a bitch in front of my people. I don't need that shit, all right? It's hard enough to be in charge of people's lives without some dick cutting you down. And that violence before with my dad, that didn't help.
Yeah, well, your dad was being an asshole.
What's wrong with him?
He's got a heart condition. He takes nitroglycerin tablets pretty regularly. I've seen a few bad attacks that he couldn't get over and needed to go to the hospital.
Yeah, that's not really an option right now.
I'm just trying to keep him relaxed.
He's got a temper.
He's got a temper.
Ah, fuck you!
Yeah, he doesn't mean it.
Just a little bit.
Yeah?
We've got kids here, families.
Kids here. Families.
He and I are a family.
I'm just saying some people can't handle a temper like that. Hell, barely seems like you can.
It's just his way. Don't make him the reason everything's screwed. Where's her mom?
Savannah, I think.
Oh, you guys aren't together.
Oh, no, I'm not her dad. I found her in a house when getting out of Atlanta. She'd been surviving by herself. I think the girl's parents didn't make it.
Oh.
I heard an answering message. They were in Savannah. She was home with a sitter. It wasn't good.
Well, she's lucky to have you.
What do you think about all this?
What do you think about all this?
What is there to think? The dead are up, walking around, eating people, and turning them into more of them. I mean, Jesus.
We need to stick together and get through this.
You're from here?
You're from here?
I work at Warner Robins, the Air Force base.
Yeah, I know it. Pilot?
Nah, just mechanical admin stuff. I deal with a bunch of shitheads and bureaucrats all day. Sometimes a plane, if I'm lucky. You?
I work up at UGA.
Was anyone here when you guys got the pharmacy?
Was anyone here when you guys got here?
No, this place was pretty wrecked. We pulled a couple of bodies out of the office. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Did you know anybody here?
Yeah, the owners, they were, we were close.
I'm sorry. We found an older couple in the office. Dad hauled them out in case they weren't really dead. I'm gonna get back to him now.
All right, let's, open the office.
Can't think about them in here.
All right. Take a look at the alley.
This door leads to the back alley.
Let's see what else. First aid kit.
First aid kit.
Let's see if we can do anything with that.
Luckily, there's nothing I need in here.
The bedding.
My parents came in here hoping to survive. But it looks like...
So his parents own the shop. The pharmacy.
A hero, maybe. Or a protector, at least. There's a photo over there.
Let's pick that up.
Find anything?
This picture. A photo of the family owned the place.
It's a photo of the family who owned this place. Might help us track down the keys to the office.
I know who you are. You're Lee Everett. You're a professor at Athens who killed a state senator who was sleeping with your wife. This is your parents' store. Folks around town know the owner's son got himself a life sentence, but I'm a reporter for WABE in Atlanta. I paid attention to that trial. Maybe you're a murderer, but I don't really care. Frankly, that's a skill that might come in handy. Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
No.
No. I've been sticking to first names for a reason.
Well, good. You seem like an okay guy, and the last thing we need is drama out there. You've got this little girl to take care of, and... Look, don't make me wrong on this.
I don't plan to.
Good. Because if this lasts longer than a few days, and you're a detriment to the group, then we'd have a problem.
I hear you.
I'll just keep it to myself.
How can I trust you?
How can I trust you?
You can't, I suppose. But you don't have many other options.
Good stuff right there. It just came out. It was like, boom, I know who you are. Everything about you. Good stuff.
What's that?
This was my dad's cane. He'd zip around here on it from time to time.
Was he sick?
Nah, he was okay. I actually saw him whoop shoplifters with it. This cane's protected this place better than any guard dog ever could. Plus, he knew how to make it look cool. Like you with your hat.
My dad gave it to me.
See, dads are smart like that.
There's a door to the pharmacy.
I'll clear this door for when we find the keys. Better get this door clear, huh?
Can I help?
Sure. Here we go. Watch your fingers in the drawers.
Young little whippersnapper. How are you doing?
How are you doing?
Yeah, it's not that heavy.
How about with everything outside?
It's not good.
No, it's not.
But I think it'll be okay.
Okay, here we go.
I love your face.
Do you have kids?
No.
You don't have a family?
What do your parents do?
What do your parents do?
My mom is a doctor, and my dad is an engineer.
Those are good jobs.
What's your job?
I teach history and writing and things like that.
Like social studies?
Yeah, like that.
I hated social studies.
You didn't
studies.
Answer my question.
All right, a little further.
I love how he's avoiding the question.
Why don't you want to talk about your family? Do they, like, hate you?
Smart little girl. I hope not. It's just complicated.
I hope not. It's just complicated. That's all.
Why?
It just is.
But you love them, right?
Yeah, of course. Look, my family's gone, and I just wish things would have been different.
Yeah.
I killed someone.
I got into a fight once.
And what happened?
And it ended really badly. After that, I wasn't allowed to talk to my family.
That's so sad.
Let's move this thing. Are you okay?
I hurt my finger.
Is it bleeding?
A little.
I'll find you a bandage.
All right, folks. We're gonna stop here. And there's not a lot for me to comment on during this game. There's a lot of dialogue, but it's great. It is a great game, great characters, and the more you get into it, it's just pretty amazing game, one of the best games I ever played, so.
Lee?
Yeah?
Alright.
What if my parents are home and I'm not there?
Thanks for watching, and until next time. Tingle.